The U.S. and Europe have no political strategy in Syria. This will lead to continued instability and it will hurt the Syrian people, including the Kurds. This is what four scholars, two British and two American, said on Thursday at the Hudson Institute in Washington. Lina Khatib is head of the Middle East program at London's Chatham House. She expects that Syria's civil war will continue.
At the moment, we don't see an end in sight to the Syrian conflict, mainly because there is no strategy in the West for ending the conflict politically. We see military activity taking place, we see efforts to deal with the humanitarian dimension, but these are just angles of the conflict. The main driver of the conflict, which is political, remains unaddressed, and as long as it's unaddressed, the conflict will continue.
Tony Badran of the Foundation for the Defense of Democracies explained that one problem in Rojava is that Salah Muslim, head of the PYD, is very ambitious and does not want to work with KRG President Masoud Barzani.
When the ISIS campaign, anti-ISIS campaign started, when the PYD saw that it had U.S. support directly that it could leverage, they became more intransigent, and then they completely rejected any form of power sharing, if you want to call it that, with Barzani and the Peshmerga of Barzani in Syrian Kurdish areas. Our use of the Kurds, the PYD Kurds, in the anti-ISIS campaign has had the effect of making them more intransigent and more ambitious, because they were capable of expanding their territorial reach as a result. United States support for the YPG is very, very specific. It has to do with the campaign against ISIS, period. And it doesn't have any other interest or any other purpose.
Unfortunately, the scholars who spoke today gave a sad prognosis for what can be expected in Syria: continued civil war and considerable uncertainty about the future for Rojava. Laurie Mylroie, Kurdistan 24, Washington, D.C.